If you want to get in contact with me, the best way to do it is on Instagram. If you just want to say what up, if you want to tell me you love my videos, you can tell me that you hate my videos, but the best way to do that is on Instagram. Peace, y'all. Johnny Fastlane here. So, Trippie Redd and Lil God at Beef on Instagram, and Megan Thee Stallion visits French Montana in the hospital. Plus, Lil TJ responds to Top 5. Let's talk hip hop.
Supposed to be my brother. You under my ex baby mama pictures talking about you fine. And you supposed to be my brother. I done been in the trenches with you. You done showed me your hood and all type of weird shit. Like, what type of shit that is, bro? I ain't on no rapper nigga shit. I ain't on none of that. That's you. You being a bitch. That's some bitch nigga shit. And on my mama. If you don't think that's some bitch nigga shit, I'ma beat on you. Everything I love. That's some whole nigga shit, bro.
So that was Trippie Redd, right? And actually, he sent that as a DM to Lil Got It, right? So the whole situation is that Trippie Redd is kind of upset at Lil Got It and basically saying that he's not his bro or he didn't follow the bro code because he saw that Lil Got It was leaving comments under his ex's photos on Instagram, right? So the whole situation is, right, that Trippie Redd sends that to him basically saying, hey, I thought we were friends. I thought we were boys. It's not just somebody that I used to mess with. This is somebody that I actually had a relationship. This is somebody who I got pregnant and she had an abortion. This is my ex-baby mama is what Trippie Redd is calling her and all this, right? Trippie Redd's upset. He said, you took me to your hood. You showed me where you grew up at. Y'all are weirdos and blah, 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 right? It's crazy because the girl that they're talking about is Coi Leray, right? And yeah, maybe she was Trippie Redd's girlfriend, but it's not like she's Trippie Redd's baby mom's because she never had a kid by him. If she had an abortion or whatever, that was that during the relationship or whatever the case may be, but she's not your baby mom. She's not your ex-baby mom, nothing. She's your ex-girlfriend, right? But also this girl, Coi Leray, is also an artist, right? And so is she not supposed to date anybody at all, ever, you know, once she breaks up with Trippie Redd? I don't know why Trippie Redd is still trying to claim this girl, even though they're exes, right? So Lil God It actually saw this and put it up on his Instagram and basically put the caption, this is what you send me. So I guess this is my love letter, right? Trippie Redd out now. This is the number one sucker in the game. Hood baby, talk to him, right? So basically he's saying like, yo, you're a sucker if you're messaging me about some girl who's your ex just because I'm flirting with her on Instagram, right? Then Lil God It actually went on live. Somebody asked him about it, and he responded to that person talking about Trippie Redd.
He mad about a comment that we both been coming on each other's sheet. He really mad because I did a song with her, and she dropped and she had my tattoos on the cover of the cup. The single cover, she got my, man, get your crappy bag, you better be mad about it. She ain't fucking with, a female ain't fucking with me, I ain't fucking, I'm not gonna do all this shit about no female, she ain't fucking with me. That's all I'm saying. She ain't fucking with me, she ain't fucking with me. I ain't finna do this, I'm not the type of nigga, I'm not finna do that. It's a 1,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, And, you know what I'm saying? Yachty. And got that. You know what I'm saying? I don't listen to you. You need to talk about you, my brother. I don't even know you. Where you were when I was just in a hurt. Don't know. Don't know where you were. Don't know you.
So basically, Lil Got It ain't even really stunting the whole situation, right? He says if the girl wants to be with you, she could be with you. If she wants to be with whoever, she could be with them. If she don't want to be with me, that's fine. There's millions of women out here in these streets, right? Also, he pointed out the fact that, yeah, you trying to say that you upset or whatever like that because I was flirting with her on her Instagram, but we're not homeboys, right? He was like, where was you when when I was broke, right? Where was you when I was coming up in the hood, right? Yeah, we met and we were friends, you know, in the industry, and I think that you're cool, or I thought that you were cool, and we hit it off because we both like make the same kind of music and run in the same circles, but you didn't grow up with me, right? Little Gotta is from Atlanta, Trippy Red is from Ohio. We weren't homeboys. And as a matter of fact, when Trippy Red was big and famous and, you know, beefing with 6ix9ine and coming out with his first music and his first mixtapes and everything like that, Little Gotta was still in the hood. Little Gotta was still trapping, right? So we didn't come up together, but we met once I became famous because you were already a celebrity and I thought you were cool. You thought I was cool and we hit it off, but we're not boys. There's no bro code to follow, right? It's not like you're my best friend and I'm getting with my best friend's ex. You're somebody I know in the industry. You're an associate, you're a rapper, right? We were cool. But you know who else I'm also cool with? Coi Leray. She's a rapper too, right? And she is dope. She's also from New Jersey, also didn't grow up with Trippy Red. It's not like they were high school sweethearts and he made her hot and he made her famous. Trippy Red met this girl in the industry just like he met Little Got It in the industry, and now he's mad that Little Got It and Coi Leray are flirting on Instagram, right? Also, Little Got It pointed out the fact that Trippie Redd is probably upset because Coi Leray and Little Got It actually came out with a song called Big. And on that album, artwork of the song called Big, Coi Leray has Little Got It's tattoo on her face, right? It's just like a Photoshop kind of thing, but it's just showing like she got Little Got It's tattoo on her face. It's just cool, like artwork or whatever like that. And Little Got It suspects that Trippie Redd is probably upset about that too, right? But look, Trippie Red kind of does seem like a sucker right here, because it's like, come on, man, you're trying to put a claim to a female who, one, you're not together, two, you met while you were in the industry, you thought you and Little Got It was boys, and you know what? Coi Leray been dissing Trippy Red all over Instagram for the last 2 months anyway, so why would you want to claim that anyway, right? Just let her fly, let her be, right? Worry about your current girlfriend, right? And that kind of brings me to my point, because Trippy Red is like one of those people, and we all know those people who are like serial relationship people, right? Like they'll be in one relationship for a long ass time, they'll get out of it and jump into a new relationship with somebody else for a long time, jump out of it and jump into another relationship, so on and so forth, right? They never give themselves time to be single, and they put a lot of stock and everything into those relationships, right? And I think that Trippy Red is like that type of person, and he's just really making himself look kind of corny a little bit by trying to claim a girl who, one, you're not with, one's not claiming you, and two, is just out here having fun. Nobody was thinking about Trippy Red, right? For you to make a video and DM it to Little Got It is pretty crazy. So shout out to Little Got It for putting that on his Instagram and exposing Trippy Red, man. Let me know what y'all think about this in the comments.
Get your motherfucking ass off this motherfucking bed and go home. Dang, they can't keep a real nigga down.
All right, so that was Megan Thee Stallion visiting French Montana in the hospital, right? In a couple days, like I reported on French Montana how he was in his crib. The police were called because they thought there was a burglary, but it wasn't, right? But when the police got to the door, they saw that French Montana was looking really crazy, like not crazy as in but crazy as in like sick. And that they called the ambulance so that they could come and pick him up, right? Turns out that he had like migraines and he was dehydrated and he had an elevated heart rate almost to the point where he was having a heart attack, right? I don't think that French Montana had a heart attack, and if he did, they're not saying that he did, but he has been in the hospital ever since then, right? So it's weird because nobody knew that French Montana was still in the hospital until Megan Thee Stallion went to go visit him, when French Montana announced that he has still been in the hospital from that time. So now French Montana's been in the hospital for 6 days in the ICU because he was having issues with his heart and everything like that, right? It's scary, right? And you see Meg Thee Stallion is like, get your ass up and go home, right? She's like, go home. She just wants him to be better. So she's like kind of being funny, but at the same time, get up and go home. Like, because when we hear that French Montana has gone home, then we know French Montana is okay, right? It's crazy, man. And French Montana's young, man. He's probably like, I don't know, 35, 36 or whatever like that. Definitely not the age to be having a heart attack, right? But it's all about eating right, your diet, traveling so much when you don't get a chance to rest, maybe drugs or whatever like that. But again, I don't really see French. I don't think that French Montana really does drugs like that, right? Maybe he might smoke a little weed. I don't know if he snips coke. But anyway, that's not what we're here for, right? The whole thing, we're here because we just got to make sure that French Montana is okay, right? Protect French Montana at all costs. And that's real talk, right? Like, yo, my prayers go out to him. I hope that he's good. He seems like he's in good spirits. He doesn't even really look all that sick, right? But just because you don't look sick on the outside doesn't mean that you're not sick on the inside, right? So, you know, prayers go out to French Montana, and I hope that he does get well, and I hope that he's at least home for Thanksgiving with his family and stuff like that, yo. Let me know what y'all think about this in the comments.
Words to my mother. That little nigga clipped the shit out of that video. That was his highlight. That video right there that he tried to post, that was his highlight. Don't ever, ever, ever in your life, any one of y'all niggas think y'all gonna come over me and play with me, I'ma slap the shit out of you. I'm gonna slap the shit out of this other nigga too. But that nigga ran away from me. He ran. And I stopped chasing his ass, he made that little video. I ain't never seen no shit like that in my life. That's what I don't like talking about. I don't like giving niggas clout, bro. But shit, niggas know my, if you know me, you know my body. I was gonna fuck that little nigga up. He was running. And then when the video ended, he ran again. He ran again. I swear to God. I ain't never seen no shit like that in my life, bro. I was just like, damn. Cloud chase to the max. Then the nigga posted it. I'm like, yo, what the fuck? Little nigga ran from me and posted the video. Yo, he ran from room to record.
Alright, so that was little TJ basically responding back to Top 5, right? And so for y'all that don't know what's going on, last week, little TJ was in Toronto, right? Top 5 is a Toronto rapper. He's also like a comedian, and what he's really known for is like actually just running up on celebrities that come to his city and basically trying to take selfies with them, right? He also actually DM'd little TJ's manager asking if he could open up for little TJ, and you know, that he would actually pay to open up for little TJ, which is crazy, right? That is some sucker shit, right? So this dude's a clout chaser. They ignored his DMs. They didn't want to take a selfie with him when he ran up on him in Canada. And so basically Top 5 got his feelings hurt, and then he tried to quote unquote expose little TJ and try to act like he's a sucker.
Fuck God! Fuck right here! Fuck! Them GG's got you! Fuck, you fucking goof! Come to the corner then! Stop doing it for the camera. Come to the corner. Come to the corner. Come. TJ, what? We don't have nothing. Just come. Come. Yo, blow this kid's head off. Yo, come, you fucking. We don't have nothing. Just come. Come. Yo, blow this kid's head off. Yo, come, you fucking.
So that was basically Top 5 taunting little TJ. You see little TJ's like, yo, suck it, suck it. And Top 5 is basically like, yo, come here, fight me. We ain't got nothing. And then turns around and go, blow this kid's head off, kid. You know, whatever like that in his like weird, funny, stupid accent, right? The whole thing is that I feel like little TJ did the right thing. I mean, you're in Canada, you're in a different country. You're not in New York. Little TJ's from the Bronx. If Top 5 was in the Bronx, or if Top 5 was in Manhattan or in Brooklyn, or anywhere in New York, then I'm sure little TJ would have pounced on him and would have had 30 other niggas to pounce on him too. But when you out of state, you don't really know what you're doing. You don't know where you at, especially when you out of the country. You don't know the police and everything over there. That's how ASAP Rocky got caught up. So it was smart for him just to kind of chill and let that fly, right? He responded. He basically said like, yo, this dude was editing the video. He only showed you a little piece. He showed you this. Then he was running. He took that quick video and started running again. And with all of this, I kind of believe little TJ, right? Because Top 5 just seems like the type of person to be a clout chaser. Nobody in the streets ever said Top 5 was trill. Nobody ever said, yo, he's a G. Nobody's co-signing this dude. Tory Lanez ain't co-signing him. Drake ain't co-signing him. I'm just thinking about rappers and people that are known from Toronto, right? And little TJ is the man, especially here in New York. So come on now. I mean, like, it's all sucker shit. And we know that Top 5 was clout chasing. Jason, right? But I bet you won't try that shit in New York, right? I bet you won't try that shit on the train, right? You know what I'm saying? Try that shit on the train, right? But I'm sure that he won't, right? Because Top 5 knows that he ain't safe over here like he's safe in Toronto, right? After that little altercation, Lil TJ stayed in Toronto. He even went to the mall. He even walked around and took pictures and signed autographs for a bunch of fans in the mall. Lil TJ was not scared at all. And at the end of the day, it really looks like Top 5 is a sucker and a clout chaser, right? But hey, that's what's going on. Let me know what y'all think about this and everything else in the comments down below. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe. Make sure you hit that notification bell. Follow me at Johnny Fast Lane on Instagram, and y'all already know what to do. Peace.